David Weiss is a grifter who sells an app where you can see how the Sun-Moon system works on a flat Earth. In this video, I will concentrate on the basics of this app. It is founded on the assumption that the Sun and the Moon moves in concentric circles above the flat Earth in a trajectory that moves from the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn. No flat earther has been able to answer the question which force keeps the Sun aloft within its circular motion and which force is responsible for the change in the radius of this trajectory. This app has been debunked many times by now, but I started to wonder, does a circular motion on a constant altitude conform with the reality we can see and test every day? I decided to study this. I live in the city of Leiden in the Netherlands, and I started with as little assumptions as possible. Assumptions a flat earther wouldn't be able to deny. 1. The distance from Leiden to the North Pole is 4,205 kilometers. The distance from Leiden to the equator is 5,796 kilometers. The distance from the equator to both tropics is 2,605 kilometers. These distances can be easily checked. Leiden is at a latitude of 52.16 degrees, that is 37.84 degrees from the North Pole, or 2,270.4 nautical miles, or 4,204.78 kilometers. The other distances can be calculated the same way. Most flat earthers recognize the 60 nautical miles per degree formula. It's the only way they can reconcile their flat Earth with the celestial navigation. They are wrong, but nevertheless. On the website SunCalc, I looked up the altitude of the Sun at its culmination, its highest point during the day in Leiden at various dates. These data are very accurate as I measured myself on the 10th of April this year. The Sun is straight above the Tropic of Cancer at June 21, above the equator at March 20 and September 22, and above the Tropic of Capricorn at December 21. With the given distances and altitudes, you can, using simple trigonometry, calculate the height of the Sun at those moments. And they all are different, ranging from 2,166 kilometers to 5,827 kilometers. Even at both times that the Sun is straight above the equator, the height is not the same, 4,530 and 4,509 kilometers respectively. So the Sun cannot follow a circular path that is parallel to the flat Earth, as the app of David Weiss suggests it does. What trajectory should the Sun have to follow in order to comply with the given altitudes at different days? I looked up the altitude of the Sun again once a week, starting at the 25th of March 2024. I made the fourth assumption, The moving of the Sun from Cancer to Capricorn will take place gradually, that is, with a constant distance every day. And I calculated the height of the Sun using the same method as I did with the equinoxes. Putting the results in a diagram resulted in this strange graph. Mind you, this is not a depiction of the Sun's trajectory. It's a depiction of the Sun's elevation above the city of Leiden at its culmination point on the flat Earth during 1 year. The flat Earthers have an additional problem. Not only have they to explain which force keeps the Sun up in the sky in its circular motion, and which force moves the Sun from Capricorn to Cancer and back, now they have to explain which force makes the Sun hopping up and down during its journey through the sky. Anyway, the model of the Sun movement that Dave Wise pictures in this app does in no way conform with real-life data. And it can't. He's not only a grifter, he's also a con man.